I think when young people receive a diagnosis, a difficult diagnosis, a life-limiting diagnosis, I think when they start interacting with the healthcare system, their expectation isn't that all their problems are going to go away, or if they come see a counselor that's going to fix all their problems. I've yet to have someone expect that of me, right? I think what we in the healthcare system try to do, and especially those of us who are working specifically with AYAs and younger folks, that we're there to help with some coping strategies, maybe some insight, maybe some gentle suggestions, and sort of ways to navigate the healthcare system. But people are experts in their own lives, right? That's the same reason why people don't like unsolicited advice from their friends and family members who say, you should try this, or I read about this supplement that you can get off the internet that cures cancer, right? You gotta be really really delicate with stuff like that, and really careful with stuff like that, because you're not there to live their life for them or solve their problems for them, but to be a support, be a sounding board sometimes, and also to provide some suggestions, gentle suggestions along the way, but only using those that work for the person themselves.